Great day, everyone! I hope that by the time you are watching this video, you are all happy, healthy, and safe. In today's lesson, we'll talk about filling out forms accurately, forms such as school forms and bank forms. Now, I have a few questions. As a grade 5 student, have you even wondered why do we need to learn how to fill out a form? And what the forms look like? Or have you seen a form for an instance? Well, some may answer yes, but for those who will answer no, you probably have seen one before, but you just didn't recognize it. Here are some examples of forms. We have school forms, like the registration form, Form 137, and Form 138. We also have bank forms like cash deposit slip, withdrawal slip, and e-check. There will be times that we will be asked to fill out forms for certain documents. This may be at the school, the bank, or the office. Your mama, papa, or kuya and ate might have filled out the form a couple of times. This is an important skill that one must learn. For these reasons, you need to master how to fill out forms. Before we have an in-depth understanding with the different forms, allow me to share with you a common grammar mistake that most individuals commit. Did you know that the phrase fill up cannot be used to mean the act of completing a form? O kapag nagsasagot tayo ng form, hindi nararapat na gamitin ang salitang fill up sapagkat ang ibig sabihin ng pariralang ito ay to make something full, generally with a liquid. Ibig sabihin, ang fill up ay ang pagpuno sa isang bagay na kadalasan ay mga liquid o likido tulad ng tubig. The appropriate expression to use when completing a form is fill out. O ang nararapat na gamitin ay ang salitang fill out. So, please don't ask anyone to fill up a form because they will not be able to do it. Ask them to fill in or fill out a form instead. At the end of the lesson, you will be able to first, fill out forms accurately, and second, appreciate the importance of filling out forms accurately. With that, let's get started. Before we begin, let's have a short activity. This activity will test your knowledge about filling out important forms. You just need to fill out the form below. Complete it by using the possible answers found inside the box. Please use the form provided to you. Again, pakisagutan po ang form na iyong makikita gamit ang mga impormasyong nasa kahon. You can pause the video while answering the activity. Then, press the play button when you're done answering it. Maaari mong i-pause ang video habang ikaw ay nagsasagot at kung tapos ka na, ay maaari mo na itong i-play. Now, let us answer the activity. What are you going to write in the name? Very good! It is Royce L. Cabrera. How about in grade and section? Exactly! We will put Grade 5, Maagap. Now, what will you write about in the age and sex? Great! For the age, we have 10, and for sex, we have male. Are you getting the right answers? Good to know! Now, what are we going to write in teacher? Great job! We will put Miss Rina B. Makaraig. Then, what will you write for the address? Nice! It is Catbalogan City, Samar. How about in birthday? Exactly! December 25, 2010. What about in the country? Very good! The country is the Philippines. For the last one, what are we going to write in the school? Great job! The school of Royce is San Roque Elementary School. Did you get all the right answers? If yes, it's good to know that you already have the knowledge about filling out important forms. Thus, it is okay if you didn't get all the correct answers. You can master the significant points in filling out the form if you will give your full attention to our lesson today. Before we proceed, kindly get a pen and paper to jot down all the important points in the discussion. We are going to discuss types of forms that you need to be familiarized. We have school registration form, cash deposit slip, and withdrawal slip. Let's talk about it one by one. The first one, school registration form. It is used to register students in any educational institutions. Ito yung sinasagutan para sa pag-i-enroll ng isang mag-aaral para mabilis na makuha yung personal records ng estudyante para sa school record. This is an example of the student registration form. It contains the name of the student, his or her birth date, sex, complete address, and the name of both parents or guardian. It also has the name of the school and the student's LRN or learner reference number. Now, LRN is a 12-digit number assigned by the Department of Education to each student as he goes through the basic education program. Ang LRN ay ang naka-assign na numero sa isang mag-aaral habang siya ay nag-aaral ng elementary hanggang high school or grade 1 hanggang grade 12. Lastly, never forget the signature over printed name. Dapat ang pangalan ay nakasulat ng nasa malalaking titik. The format of student registration form varies depending on the school. Hindi pare-pareho ang itsura ng student registration form at ang mga impormasyon na kailangan punan ng estudyante. Ito ay nakadepende sa paaralan na iyong pinag-aaralan o pag-aaralan. Our next form is the cash deposit slip. It is a small paper form that the person includes with the bank deposit to show how much money he or she is putting in a bank account. This is an example of a cash deposit slip. It contains the deposit date, name, and bank account number of the depositor, and the amount to be deposited in the form of checks or cash. Also, the important thing, we have the signature of the depositor. Itong form na to yung ginagamit sa mga bank transaction kapag magde-deposit ka ng pera sa iyong account sa banko. Now, a person who deposits or places money in a bank account is called a depositor. Kapag nag-deposit ka ng pera sa banko, ang tawag sa'yo ay depositor. We are now going to know the steps on how to fill out a deposit slip. First, write your name and bank account number. Dapat na ikaw lang ang nakakaalam ng iyong bank account number upang maiwasan na ma-access ng iba ang iyong account. Then, supply additional details such as transaction date and any branch information required. Sagutan ng iba pang mga additional information na makikita sa form. Now, for our third step, we need to list the cash amount breakdown of your deposit and the total amount thereafter. take note the word cash amount breakdown. Bukod sa total amount ng iyong ide-deposit, dapat ay nakalista rin ang mga piraso ng pera na iyong ide-deposito. Halimbawa, makikita sa iyong screen, ayan pong may bilog, mayroong 2 piraso ng 1,000, 1 piraso ng 500, at 5 piraso ng 100. Sa katabi nito ay makikita ang amount ng pera at sa baba ay ang total. Sa pamamagitan nito ay makikita kung kulang ba o sobra ang perang iyong idedeposito. Now for our last step, you need to affix your signature over printed name found on the lower part of the form. Never forget your signature over printed name o ang iyong pangalan na lahat ay nakasulat sa malalaking letra bago mo pirmahan. Our third form is the withdrawal slip, which is a small paper form which has to be filled out before making a withdrawal of money from a bank. Ang form na ito ay kinakailangang sagutan bago mag-withdraw o maglabas ng pera galing sa iyong account sa banko. After filling out the bank slip, a person signs on it in the presence of a bank teller. A bank teller is an employee of the bank whose job is to help bank customers with their banking needs, such as depositing checks or cash, or making a withdrawal. Let us now discuss the steps on how to fill out a withdrawal slip. First, write your name and also the date. Then, write the desired amount of your withdrawal in words and in figures. Also, never forget to write your account number. Finally, affix your signature on the signature line found on the lower part of the form. Remember to only do this or to only sign your paper when a bank teller will witness you signing it. Filling out withdrawal slip is really easy. Just never forget your important details, specifically the account number. We are now done discussing the types of forms. So again, what are the 3 forms that we have discussed? Great job! So the forms that we have discussed are the school registration form, cash deposit slip, and the withdrawal slip. The first one, the school registration form, is used to register students in any educational institutions. Ito ay yung form na ginagamit upang makapag-enroll ang mga estudyante sa mga paaralan. The second one is the cash deposit slip, which is used to show how much money a depositor is putting in a bank account. Ito naman ay yung form na kailangan upang makapagpasok ng pera sa account sa banko. And the last one is the withdrawal slip, which has to be filled out before making a withdrawal of money from a bank. Ito naman ay yung form na kailangang sagutan bago makapaglabas ng pera mula sa account sa banko. As a whole, there are particular forms that you have to fill out as a requirement for admission to a school or when transacting in a bank. Accuracy is very important in filling out these forms. Ang bawat impormasyon na ating inilalagay sa mga ganitong form ay dapat na tama at totoo. Again, accuracy is very important. I hope you understand our lesson for today about filling out forms accurately. To test what you have learned today, in your notebook, please fill out the student registration form with your accurate information. Again, please fill out the student registration form with your accurate information. You can pause the video while answering the activity. Then, press the play button when you're done answering it. Maaari mong i-pause ang video habang ikaw ay nagsasagot at kung tapos ka na ay maaari mo na itong i-play. Now that you play the video, let us answer the form. In the student name, the order will be surname first, followed by your first or given name, then the middle name. For example, we have De La Cruz for the last name, Juan for the first name, and Sanchez for the middle name. Then, for the school name, which is the name of your school, we have an example here, which is Malaya Elementary School. For the LRN, this will be your student number. It is commonly found on your ID or at the top portion of your report card. Here is an example. Next is your birth date, which follows the format of month, day, and year. For example, month of May, day of 18, and year of 2005. May 18, 2005. The next section is sex, which is male for boy or female for girls. You can now write your complete address that should have street or barangay, city or municipality, province, and country. For example, we have Barangay Pulido, Carmona, Cavite, Philippines, followed by the name of your father or your tatay or papa, and the name of your mother or nanay or mama. For example, we have the father's name, which is Jose C. de la Cruz, and the mother's name, Jocelyn S. de la Cruz. Never forget your signature over printed name. Write your name in all capital letter before signing it. For example, alright. Now, did you answer the form correctly? Good to know if you answered it right. If not, it is okay. We can still improve it. Never hesitate to ask some questions and clarifications if something bothers you. That will be all for today. I hope you understand our lesson. Thank you for listening and have a great day ahead!